Are we all warmed up now?
It's risen. It's rise. Let it rise.
Warmed up. We are warm.
Oh, when the saints
come marching in.
Oh, when the saints go marching in. Lord, I want to be in that number. When the saints go marching in.
Come marching in.
Go march.
Oh, when the saints go marching in. Are we ready? Intermission.
You're the same God today, and the same God tomorrow. Help me see the victory you already see. Let my faith be today what it will be tomorrow. When I see the victory you already see. Abundant beyond what we could ask or think. We call on your name, Jesus. Whoa, whoa, yeah. By the power of your name and all for your glory, the sick are healed, soul is filled, the battle has been won. On your promise I stand. In faith I believe it, that what I pray in your name, it's already done. Oh, let your will be done. Oh, we need a miracle. You are the miracle maker. Gotta be impossible. There is no power greater, exceeding abundant beyond what we could ask or think. We call on your name, Jesus. Whoa, whoa, yeah, yeah. In the waiting, you get the glory. In the healing, you get the glory. In the breaking, you get the glory. And in the breakthrough, you get the glory. In the waiting, you get the glory. In the healing, you get the glory. In the breaking, you get the glory. In the breakthrough, you get the glory. You get the glory.
You get the glory.
You get the glory.
You get the glory.
You get the glory. You get all the glory. We need a miracle. You are the miracle maker. God of the impossible. There is no power greater. Exceeding abundant. Beyond what we could ask or think. We call on your
We can hear you breathing. That's a good thing. Yeah.
is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I'm desperate for you. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my day. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I'm desperate for you. Without you. And I'm desperate for you. And I'm lost without you. Lost without you. I'm lost without you. I'm lost without you. I'm lost without you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Good morning. It's good to see people coming back. Been a tough 2 years. We kind of got cocky around here. We were kind of thinking, okay, we missed the bullet, you know, and then it hit us. So everybody got whacked. So we have a few things for our announcements coming back on. And February 6th is the first Sunday of February, so that's our potluck day, and we celebrate February birthdays. And also communion. So that's our first Sunday of the month is usually pretty busy. And then on the Saturday, the 12th, is going to be our fellowship breakfast. We didn't have one the last month because of things. But we just want to invite everybody to come to the fellowship breakfast on that Saturday. And I'm going to kind of leave you with this. You all, some of you know what my career job was years ago. And it was a good job, but it had a lot of issues. Unfortunately, now police officers are dealing with many issues. They don't get the support of the public. They don't get the support of their administration. And then, I think it's off. Now it's fixed. But then they do what they think is right at the time that they do it under great stress. And then they're investigated by the federal government. So people aren't going to law enforcement anymore. The past 3 or 4 days, we've lost 2 police officers from murder. One was killed on his motorcycle, and one committed suicide. So this is happening more and more and more. So what I want to say is, remember law enforcement in your prayers, because it's a tough thing anymore. With that.
Hand sanitizer. Good morning! Yeah, got y'all. Some of you just went, what happened? I found my hand sanitizer. Now, most of you know I used to surf. It's been a while. But they used to have this wax called sex wax. All right, now everybody's going, oh, what's he talking about? It was grape flavored. And then there was some tropical fruit flavored stuff. Well, I found hand sanitizer that smells like that. I couldn't find it for like 2 months. I was freaking out. I was having withdrawals. But I found it, and now it's back, and I love the smell. So I'm always going to smell like grape or tutti frutti, whatever it is, hand sanitizer, because it's just good stuff. All right. Helena. Helena is an older lady that started coming to this church, I want to say almost a year ago. Right, around the beginning of summertime, yeah. And it's kind of interesting because she started coming, and she got a spark in her eye. And, you know, Paula was just saying that had it not been for her finding the church and coming, that she probably wouldn't be with us right now. All right, so she had some things on her bucket list that she wanted to do. And because all the ladies just kind of said, you go and do. She got a little spark, and she went and did the things that were left on her bucket list. And it's kind of interesting because the grace and mercy of God just played through the whole summer for her. Got to spend time with her husband, Ralph, who usually sits there, a very quiet man, gentle giant. All right, and it's kind of interesting because Helena now is entering into the last phases of being in this place and getting ready to go to the place that was prepared for her. As a matter of fact, that brings me to this. My February series is called I've Gone to Prepare a Place for You. Now, I've never spoken on this before, so it's going to be good. But she's now in the Gosnell home in Scarborough. And I spoke to Ralph yesterday, and Ralph's in really good spirits. She's getting ready to depart from this earthly tent to go into our heavenly home, all right? This is what life is. This is what life is. And that's why it's so important to remember, I've gone to prepare a place for you. So I'm going to go over and visit Helena this afternoon and just pray with her a little bit. I'm not sure how coherent she is, but I just want to reassure her that it's okay to go. It's okay to go. See, because that's a lot of times people are hesitant to just go. They struggle wicked bad. And it's like, hey, you're done here. Enter into his presence, see? So keep Ralph in your prayer. Keep the whole family in your prayer because, you know, it's just this. For some people, when they don't know the saving grace of Christ, they don't understand that.